Lots of the internet was broken today because one of Amazon Web Services server farms was having huge problems out here on the East Coast, which ripple effect because of how interconnected the internet is, right? What did that take down? So that took down logins for things like Disney Plus and Netflix, PUBG, and the Riot things like League of Legends and Valorant, Prime Streaming, Alexa AI, Kindle, Amazon Music, The Ring and the Wyze smart cameras, services like Tinder, Roku, Chrome, Cash App, Venmo, and yeah! So apparently, as of an update that I saw a little bit earlier, they cleaned up most of their stuff, but there's still some things hanging. So, hey, if you're on the internet tonight, then it looks like you dodged that bullet, or at least, you know, you're here after the aftermath. Sintel, did you run into any internet troubles today?
Man, fortunately, I did not get hit by any of it. Actually, until when I read the breakdown of what we're going to be talking about, I was like, I must have been on some very good servers that had some stability on it, but I know and completely understand how frustrating that can be. I'm just glad they're going to clear it up, especially Disney Plus, because we got episode 4 of Hawkeye coming out. And
are you a midnight watcher?
Up and running.
Are you? You got to watch that.
Yeah, not as much as I used to be, but I just don't want anything. I want to be able to turn it on and it just works. I don't want, the worst thing in the world is like, you know how like you get that taste in your mouth or something, and then somebody serves you something different. It's like that with my streaming services as well. I want to watch Hawkeye now. I want to watch Hawkeye right now. So I'm glad they cleared it up.
Well, this is our nightmare dystopian future of consolidation of everything. If the one person who holds the bag goes down, then all the dominoes fall. So is there a way around this? I don't know, because, man, it's expensive running these kinds of services. But here we are. So thank you for joining us, everyone. You are here. So I'm going to do a quick hit of video game and media news. So in a teaser for Thursday night's Game Awards, and that the Game Awards will be streaming on all kinds of platforms Thursday night at 5 p.m. Pacific, 8 p.m. Eastern. So what they showed today was a teaser of the new Paramount Plus Halo TV show. Have you gotten a chance to see this, Sintel?
I saw the teaser.
All right.
It looks good enough. I want my 7-foot Master Chief. I'm worried about scale more than anything else.
Yeah, you got it.
Which is a small, ridiculous thing to worry about. But that's
it's
my little personal, right?
Like, everyone is supposed to feel intimidated about John 1:17, right? Like, he's supposed to intimidate not just the Covenant and the, I don't know what the bad guys are called nowadays, the Banished, right? But also, like, his teammates, the regular Marines, are supposed to be in awe of him. So I don't think the scale is a small thing to ask for. I think it is central to the mystique of the character.
Yeah, I saw something that was really interesting too that I didn't realize either. So a lot of folks know that Master Chief is like 7 feet tall, like 280 pounds or something like that. Something ridiculous, like 300 some odd pounds. Well, anyways, but they compared him to the size of a grunt. And if you've played the game, you see the little bitty grunts that's running around. They look like, you know, little bitty dudes that are like nothing to worry about. But then they show the scale of a grunt as compared to Master Chief, compared to a regular human. Yo, them bad boys is like this tall.
Especially with the thing on their back, right?
Yeah, it was with the little weird ridge thing on their back. I want to see that. Like, if they get the scaling down right, that could really like add a whole new element to the Halo franchise that people may not necessarily connect with. Like, how big these things are and how dominant, like, these the Covenant? No, not Covenant. Is that what it is?
Yeah, that was the original faction. And then they just shuffled what faction they belonged to, but kept like the races, the species. But anyway, that's coming up. Like I said, look for a full trailer Thursday night. What's up? What's up?
No, I'm just saying, I just think it's brilliant too that they're releasing it tomorrow. I mean, on Thursday, right after tomorrow's release of the full campaign mode of Halo. Yeah.
Synergy, right?
Yeah. So, I mean, that's smart. I mean, you know, if you're going to get all your ducks in a row, make sure they're ready to quack. And they're all ready to quack.
And let's see, I believe that the campaign mode is unlocking 1 p.m. GMT, and that translates to what, 5 or so or 6 or so Eastern time here. So just in time for everyone to be still at work, and then maybe they'll skip out a little bit early. I don't know. Okay. All right. I won't tell. They're not watching this. Right. Keep it on the down low. All right. Everybody shut up.